I got to tell this story publicly, but when I was probably, I may have been like 10 years old, my dad's like, hey, there's a baseball player, we were in Dunedin, Florida, during spring training. He's like, there's a baseball player at the Firestone Tire that's signing autographs. You want to go? I'm like, yes. So I go, and it's a guy from Van Meter, Iowa, named Bob Feller.
Absolutely.
And Bob signed, he had a lithograph, he wrote it out to me, best wishes in your baseball, signed Bob Feller. I still have that. I got to bring that out.
I met Mr. Feller a couple of times, but it's Armin Killebrew that got me.
Oh, really? Well, you know, they did a thing. There's a thing called Fastball. You should see it. It's on Netflix. And they kind of say, who threw the fastest? And Feller, you know, he did, the way they measured it then, he would throw with the motorcycles going 90 miles. But when they would do it was closer to the plate than what the radar guns now. So they basically took all that throughout history, they controlled it, and basically Nolan Ryan was the fastest and Bob Feller was the second fastest. But even faster than the guys that throw 101, 102 now, they say that Feller and Ryan were higher. Because Nolan Ryan would throw 99 on like the ray gun that would pick it up 10, 12 feet past that. So Ryan was equivalent to like 107 or something.
I saw him pitch a couple times. It was
nobody better than that. I mean, like,
he was mid-40s.
He's throwing 96 miles an hour at age 45.
Yeah, I mean, that's impressive.
We
don't want to take your time.
No, do it.
Yeah, right here.
Get in here. Come on, you want to get in? My son's 5, my wife just FaceTimed me and he's playing coach pitch to this morning, so.
Of course.
All right, good, thank you. You got it, appreciate it. Thank you to see you.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to that next team in Illinois. Sad that they're first too. Do you like it? Yeah. When did you start school? A couple weeks ago?
Yeah. How are you doing?
Good, good. Thank you. I'm doing good.
Good. How many kids do you have?
Two.
Where's
6-year-old and 8-year-old.
Oh, wow.
Okay. Back there.
Yeah, so we've got our six is in first, our five's in kindergarten, our three's in pre-K-3 now. So that's like... it's interesting. We've taken them on bus trips around Iowa, through the summer. Then when school started, we did have 3 or 4 days. We had to homeschool them on the bus. I'll tell you, it's not easy to do. I mean, we're a big homeschool state in Florida. And so just having gone through that, anytime I see a homeschool parent now, I'm like, you've learned a lot, right? Because to be able to do that, it really is important, but it's good. So thanks for coming. We appreciate it. And that's the high school?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Really? What classification?
Class A. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I did a high school game last night in Florida, and they got hit by the hurricane, so they had their first weeks of games got canceled because of the storm, so then they were able to get back going, and it's good. I mean, we had 100% power within like 7 days of the storm. There's more people without power in California than in Florida. I just had a category for it, so it's good.
You guys, we're going to go outside just in case we do get a gas.